What you gonna do?
If you guys are going to buy some grips for your PlayStation or Xbox controls, check out Fatal Grips, link and discount code in the description.
Hello boys, TR Films here and welcome to another Train Simulator 2016 video where today we're going to be driving something which has been highly anticipated to the point where I thought it got canned. And what's that I hear you are saying? Well, it is the... As soon as the career screen loads... It is the Class 68. In ScotRail livery, there she is, right there. And it's gonna be on the Edinburgh to Glasgow route today. And the scenario we're gonna be doing is ScotRail Saviour, and it's gonna be 55 minutes long with a mild difficulty. I guess that's easy/medium. That. And the description for this one is ScotRail has taken several Class 170s out of service for maintenance and has therefore roped in a small fleet of Class 68s to help run replacement service between Edinburgh and Glasgow. Check your briefing for today's stops. Okay, so it's going to be a rainy spring morning because meanwhile in the UK it's raining. And so, since I don't have anything else to say at the moment, let's bloody go start! Hopefully we'll go to plan this time. And here we are. Driver, you'll be running ScotRail's first replacement service today in the form of Class 68. Start here at Edinburgh at the controls of an express service to Glasgow, open the doors and allow passengers to board here before departing. Okay. Don't disable ECS, please. Alright, start that. Persons forward. Any doors clear. Open. Doors. And the Class 68's got some pretty... cool things about it. Just gonna get the lights on. Check if I actually put them on. Yes, I did. And what else is there? Oh yeah, so this thing's got more things in it that more things work than other dovetail things. So it's got a few little things that work. The electric train supply just saw me turn on. It's got a cab heating down here. Not sure if it actually has any effect, but we'll just leave it. I think that's off for the moment. DSD holdover, standard switch, because DSD pedal does work, which is very good indeed. And we've got desk lights, which you can work on a dimmer, which is cool. Let's get right going then. Put the rosin forward. Oh shit, forgot to put the wipers on. Silly me. There we are. And have I gone the right way? I think it was about to go then, wasn't it? Oh, the brake's on hold, that's why. Doesn't want to go this train, I'm going to tell you that right now. There we go, just had to release the brake and do all that shit. But anyway, off we go. Got a single yellow signal up ahead, so we are going to have to go. Gonna have to stop shortly, so it's gonna bring the power down a tad. Not all the way down, but just a little bit. DRE isolate, that's first, that what that little red square said. Just wondering what that said for a second. And one thing that does annoy me on this train is the brakes. I mean, that works better than the other brakes, so I'm gonna use that from now on. From here on out, I'm just going to use a dynamic brake. Because it works better than the ADS. It's not off. If it helps stop me, that is. Alright, dynamic brakes are better than the... Because the bloody brakes in this thing are hell. I'm going to say that right now. Hang on a minute. Fuck you! So that happened. Okay, here we are back again. After that little mistake. Anyway, ETS on. Doors. Compressor. DS. Heads. Heads. And wipers. As soon as you Seems the way switch goes. There we go. And anyway, because the one problem with this train is the brakes on it are absolute cancer. Because these things here, I have no idea what the hell I'm doing wrong with these brakes here. But they work similar to the TGV's brakes, where you gotta, you know, apply and then you have to hold. But I end up doing that all. I accidentally put the emergency brakes on way too often, so it's really annoying. Hopefully, I won't do it again this time and get. Actually, stop this bloody signal right here. Alright, time's bonus is 343. Let's go. Come on. And train's on point this time because I released the brake first. And hopefully it'll be happy days this time. So let's just put the power down just one. And then all the way down, just to idle. And hopefully I'll master the brakes by this. Hopefully I'll have the braking system nailed down this time. And hopefully not have it screwed over. Oh, go on, apply. There we go, apply a little bit. Then put it to hold. Ah, there we go, we've got it now. Sort off, right. Then put it back up if you want more brake. Not like that. Right, apply, hold. Apply. I'm trying not to put the bloody emergency brakes on. That's all I'm doing. Like that. And now pass again. Great. I sincerely hope this braking system isn't adopted, but here we are again. See, this is the most takes that I've had to do for a train sim video. All because these brakes suck ass! But anyway, enough ranting. Let's get this thing ready for its run. Hopefully, we'll get past that bloody signal up to the bloody sodding A market. As soon as these bloody lights come on, which they think they have. Yes, it did. Daring to put that bloody brake system in. Message: it sucks ass. And that. Anyway, that's probably why this train's called Daring, because they dared to put this braking system in. Word of warning, it sucks. At least unless I'm doing something horribly wrong with it. Right, here we go again. Notch 2 departure, hopefully this bloody works this time. And I have this bloody braking system nailed down. Quick look around the cab. I don't think the bloody cab lights are anywhere in here, are they? Is there a cab light in this, or just the desk lights? Not sure. FR, that, horn, AWS, headlight dimmer. Is that a cab light? Yep, cab light. I don't think we're gonna need a desk light now. And we're about to speed. And hopefully we get this bloody braking system nailed down. Apply for fuck's sake. And then hold. Oh, sod it hell. Yep, emergency brakes again, and we're gonna spad. Again. Great. So I told you about these brakes, man, these suck balls. I'm not even arsed now. Just wanna get this wee train going. Right. US, sod off. Lamps on. Lights on. ETS active. Whoopee. Cab light on. And just hopefully we can get this bloody train going now. Because I am literally sick of this shit now. Because these brakes suck, mark my words. Dark brake controller doesn't really work. dynamic brakes only work. Dynamic brakes don't work below 2 miles per hour. I need to just put the emergency brakes on in about 2 seconds. What the hell am I supposed to bloody do? Because these brakes are absolute cancer. I mean, hopefully more companies don't adopt this bloody braking system unless I'm doing something wrong. So let's see if... Right, that's hold. That should be brake. That should be applied, but it's not. Because, in fact, it doesn't apply at all. Unless... Oh, come on. Right, is that what you're applying now? Right. I don't want to put any more brake on, just in case it bloody screws me over. Right, release. Yeah, whoopee, you're raining now. Right, whoopee, it's raining outside. Anyway. Because I've got to put it to EB, haven't I? If it goes to EB, then it'll apply. Right, there. Right, we got to a signal. Whoopty fucking do. Woohoo. Right, let's bloody wait here now. Now we can actually do the scenario. Speaking of which, I didn't check the brief, did I? Wrong button. Let's see. Calling it Haymarket, Liffingo. Probably butchered that. Polmont, Falkirk High, Croy, and finally Queen Street. So that's a pretty decent set of stops there. And here is a number 68. That's probably what's got me in this mess in the first place. Yeah, you move. Like, haha, I can move, you can't. What's it name? What's it called? Valiant. Yeah, Valiant, nah, screw it, I'm not asked. And as soon as this bloody train goes away, we can pass. This bloody red signal right here. Hopefully it'll be soon. Yep, release. Yep, release brakes. DRA off. And, Knox 2, yeah. Let's go. Doesn't accelerate pretty fast, this train, does it? Well, I'm only giving it Knox 2, so it won't accelerate particularly fast. Knox 2 out of what? 8. Knox 2 out of 8, so, it's not going to accelerate particularly fast, though, is it? If I'm only giving it that. Now, hopefully this train don't screw me over again, because I see it now. This braking system is gonna run me into the ground. I see it now. Oh, and as we're approaching A35 zone, I can show you one of the new features of this train that Dovetail's implemented. A lot of third parties have, but it's the first time Dovetail's done it. That's right, train left button fam. It's very good indeed. Not a headlight dimmer. And then what that does, if you've don't know, is when you press it, it tells you when the back of the train passes. So when the back of the train passes at 35 signal, it should change. There you go. That's what that beep meant. That beep told me that the back of the train passed, and we can accelerate now. And I'll do it again for this 40 zone that we just passed as well. So let's accelerate to 35 miles per hour. Just going to hover over the throttle just in case the 40 zone comes. Just if the 40 zone comes after, which it has. Just going to bring the throttle down just a little bit. And completely to idle as we approach Haymarket. Of which we are due in a minute. Hopefully we should do half a mile in a minute. And hopefully the brakes don't run me into the ground. Please. Please, brakes. Please. Right. Otherwise, this will be a, otherwise, every single station will be my version of Nebworth. Let's hope not, then. Right, let's put the brakes in now. Start applying. Put it to hold. I have no idea if we're slowing down fast enough. Don't we are. More brake. Hold. Should be fine now. Right, I'm starting to hang this now. Thankfully. And we're on time for Haymarket. Hallelujah. After about 3 takes. Boom. So, look outside while we wait. Right, Haymarket. Here's a 68 I've waited about 3 months for. Because, and I think everyone else has, because I was like, yeah, 68. But, hopefully someone comes out with this in DRS livery. That'd be pretty awesome. Direct rail services livery, that'd be pretty awesome. Let's go to the back. Hey, look, the bloody passenger view has people in it. Very slightly deformed ones at that, but people nonetheless. So let's just wait here. Just hoping we don't have any accidental emergency brakes this time. Because that's the last thing we need now. Because we are at least starting to motor at this point. Which is very, very good indeed. And, right, so while we wait, let's, well, not really wait, while we, go for notch 4, try and make some time up. Well, time, which I don't really need to make up, but will nonetheless. In terms of content, next one will probably either be this, or the post-patch Marseille to Avignon route, depending on feedback. Hopefully this will get some good feedback on this one. Also, the PC upgrade in season is coming soon, so keep your eyes out for the update vlog. During which there'll be a special surprise which will be announced. So not really announced, you'll see the surprise as when the video comes out, you'll see what the surprise is. I'm not giving anything away. All I'm telling you is I'm upgrading my PC, so keep your eyes out for that update vlog, and then a new era will begin in more ways than one. So anyway, we're accelerating to 53, 54, 55. The can is making me echo. I love my coat, me. Well, Coca-Cola, not cocaine. Don't do drugs, kids. Anyway, I'm not sure who's staying. I think that's Glasgow City Stadium or Edinburgh. Whoops, my bad. Anyway, 67, 68. Watching sparks fly. I think that's go 68 in a class 68. I think that's what that means. 73. Do I bang the throttling all the way? Nah. Actually, yeah, let's do it. As soon as I get my cursor on it. Let's see, 80. 81. Currently 14 miles from Linifco. I probably butchered that. Please tell me how it's pronounced if you know in the comments below. Along with anything else. Right. Anyway, hang on a minute, the brakes, the thing's stuck. Gonna use the keyboard for that, unfortunately. There's gotta be a way I can grip that thing. Anyway, let's accelerate to 100. Hopefully I can find a nice sweet spot where I can grab this. The train does not like me at all, does it? Needless to say, it wants me to use the bloody keyboard for everything. And I'm like, no, I want to drive realistically. But no, it does not want me to drive realistically because it's not really going to let me do this. Oh, great, we're going 96. Come on. Give me a hand, fam. Come on. Where had it before? Anyway. Horn's oddly quiet. It's rather annoying. I thought we were in a tunnel then, but just a little bridge. 98, 99, oh damn it. Come on. Come on, there's nothing works. I can't ring the throttle back with the mouse cursor. I'll choose the keyboard, won't I? Right, you win this time, train, but trust me, I'll prevail eventually. And it's broken playing this game at 1080p on a 4K monitor, so everything's screwed. Look, reverse is fine. Look, reverse, I can bloody hold. But this bloody thing, the bloody power handle, it won't let me hold it. Won't let me grab it at all. Is that bugged that? I haven't a clue, just because I'm turning the resolution down. Because I'm playing at 1080p on a 4K monitor, so will that be it? Will that be what that is? I haven't a clue. But really going, we're not accelerating terribly fast anyway, but we'll have to slow down eventually because we're only 10 miles from Lifinifer. Duh, fuck it. AWS isolation. That cuts out the AWS, so if that's not your thing. Right, I think that. That's just a test, okay. I thought signal was incoming then. Yeah, we've got to slow down because we're going out at 90. Because look. Oh, yeah, if I keep my hand on it, it works. But if I let go of it, it doesn't for some stupid reason. Right, hopefully we can coast down to. What? Oh, come on. All I'll do is put it in neutral, you stupid thing. Ah, great. So I can't put it in neutral. Oh, wait. Doesn't put it in neutral save fuel? Isn't this taking fuel saving a bit too far, game? Ugh. God. Please tell me this doesn't actually happen. Why does putting it in neutral put it in emergency? Why? All I did was put it in bloody neutral. It's not like bloody putting reverse in a car. Is it? It's not like putting a car in reverse, is it? While moving forward. And oh my god, I just lost a lot of points. That's a big one, I just lost a lot of points. Yeah, go me, am I right? Hurry up and release, fam. Right, I'm only 5 bar now, so that's got to be enough to get us going. Oh, wrong way. Alright, screw it. We're going to have to cane it, aren't we? Again? Measure brake set, really? That don't matter. Right, just cane it. Let's go. Is the horn that quiet? Jesus, that is weak, fam. God, the horn, this thing is piss weak, man. Well, not only does this train accelerate slow, have crap brakes, it has the most piss weak horn in the world. Yay. Huh. But anyway, well, once it gets to the speed, it doesn't accelerate too fast. Does it accelerate too slowly on notch bloody 8? But I suppose it's reasonable nonetheless. But these suck ass. This sucks ass. This braking system right here. Screw me over so many times. It's not even funny. Oh, bad up. Trackside cam, please. Long overdue the trackside cam right here. If you hear the horn over, that'll give you a quid. No, seriously, if you could hear the horn over the engine now, I'll give you a quid. And I just saw it on the tracks of the cam as well. It's going to have to go down to 80 eventually. Hopefully this behaves. Oh, no, of course not. It doesn't. Hopefully they'll fix that. Please fix it. Alright, anyway, let's go down to That's the only way I can do it. Ding. Hopefully we'll slow down fast enough to the point where we can just coast through this. No guarantees of that though. Just in case, I'm going to put the brake in a little bit. Hold that there and release. Seems like I get the hang of these brakes now. Let's put the cab light on since we're going to go in the tunnel for a little bit. See, the rain's getting worse. Yeah, I like looking at the rain on this, because it's not only is it like nice to have, it's like I like to look at it like you shall not pass, and like haha, you can't get in here because I'm in a solid box. But anyway, we're gonna have to accelerate the back up now. Just notch 4 will do the trick just fine. Also, we're gonna accelerate, I'll probably accelerate more because 100 limit's going up, so I'll probably bang the train left button in. In fact, I will. As soon as you go over it, or pass it. And then, but it's not sure, 6, 7, 8. So it let me hold on to it then, but as soon as I let go of it, it just doesn't let me grab it with a cursor at all. It doesn't let me click or drag it or anything. Look here, you're clicking the mouse. I hope you can. It won't let me drag it at all afterwards, which is kind of annoying. Which is kind of annoying as well, because we're 4 miles from Linlithgow. I'm not sure how to pronounce that at all, but idle. I'm just gonna just slow down for that place. Linlithgow, I think it's called. Linlithgow, just call it that, Linlithgow, right. And if someone corrects me, I'll just call it that. There's a number 68. Now question is, do I put the brakes on or not? I'm not sure. Right, three miles to go, 84. Not sure whether I should or not. But we'll find out as we get closer. Yeah, it doesn't manage to put the brake in a tiny little bit. Hold. And match release him. Boom. I think I've probably slowed down too much because I've just seen 747. It's 7:48 now, so I should be accelerating if anything. See, yeah, thanks, brakes. Does this blind come down? I don't think it does it? Nah, it doesn't. Well, there's Linlithgow anyway. Mersey break, but it says SOS, so why not say save our souls? Hazard lights. Yeah, why do the hazards not put the emergency lights on? I mean, emergency brakes on rather, but just put it into neutral does. Makes no sense at all. Just gonna try and accelerate, but it's not letting me. There we are. Just so I don't lose us enough. lose as much time as I would hope. Well, not really hope, but would like, really. Because we're getting later and later as we go on, really. Like, nearly 3 minutes later as we speak now, which is kind of, which is really, really kind of crap. So, maybe I'll let Linlith go anyway, just apply brake. And then hold. Apply more. Hold there. So you're on full service now, I just saw it there. And is full service too much? I'm not sure. Well, the full service is too much, I don't really care, because all we've got to do is just stop here now. At Linlith go for, which we are 3 minutes late due to that bloody cock-up earlier. Look, I didn't know putting it in neutral would bloody put the emergency brakes on, did I? Well, no, now. So, stop giving me slack, okay? Stop giving me flack for it. So yeah, penalty, just lost 30 points. Just saw it on there. But let's just cane it. Make all that, make that time up. Limit's 100, so we can accelerate for quite a while. Alright, so it's starting to 40, 90, oh shit, that's going down to 90, that's not what I wanted to see at all. Oh great, we're due at 7:53 for bloody Polmont, really? Yeah, see, if you're late for one stage, it all goes wrong after. It stabs you in the back for the rest of the journey, because all the stations are really like a few miles between each other. And that is the biggest bitch going. Because now, there's no way I'm going to get to Polmont in a minute. I'm sorry, there's no way it's happening. Even if the bloody limit goes, yeah, whoopee, limit's going up to by 10 miles an hour. From 90 to 100, so whoopee. But it's not going to make it happen at all. Oh, great. And of course, my week-long absence is going to kick off with a bag of crap. Because I wanted to boss this scenario, but also I'm not going to. I'm going to lose all my bloody points. You know, like I did with Marseille to bloody Avignon when we did that. Bloody brakes on that screw me over because it's the same system as this. And that, that in turn, You get the idea. That in turn really screwed me over as well. That might be the scenario I do on post-patch, when I do it post-patch. Might just go for a rematch. Might do this one again later as well. I'll just see how I do on the next scenario. Hopefully the next scenario I'll redeem myself like I did on Avignon. You can see it on the map as well. We're going to have to slow down just to do that now. And we are now late for Polmont, which sucks ass. See, it all just starts as chain reaction now. I'm just gonna break as late as the dare for this one. Right, Brazil is a duh. because I'm not sure how good this train is in terms of stopping distances, but it's proving itself quite the capable one at the moment, since we're down to 57, 56, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 50. So it's proven itself quite capable, so I'm going to take the brake off a little bit. Hold it there. Hopefully it doesn't keep releasing, it'll just hold at that point. I'll release it completely for now. Is this Polmont now? Right, this is Polmont, so I'm gonna... I might just add a little bit of brake as soon as we get in, or just lay on the brake until... for as long as I dare. Right, lay on the brake for as long as we dare. She's that long. Hold it there. Oh shit, I just saw it there. We're just going off, going off, going off, going off. And we've overshot. Yeah, go me. Am I right? Gee, look how long I've overshot by. See, that's what trying to put the emergency brakes on does to you. That's what putting crappy brakes on trains does to people. They don't want to put the emergency brakes on, so they just try for dear life to not put them on. So they go so gentle with the brake, they think they're going to be... Because I'll be honest, it takes about 5 seconds before there'll be emergency brakes come on if you just leave them there. Whoa. Well, at least that wasn't a complete farce, was it? Wasn't a complete farce, at least, but 10 points is jack shit. We're due at 8 o'clock at Falkirk High, so I don't think I'm going to get there on time either. I'll be honest, I don't think I will. Because these brakes are an absolute farce. I don't know why they put these brakes in this bloody thing, honestly. If I was designing trains, I'd either combine power handle or just a brake, leave over a brake that keeps on with do it the old fashioned way, just notch brakes. Notch brakes or just a bloody lever that just does it normally rather than this shit. Cause let's be honest, the brakes in this thing are crap, let's be honest. I'm starting to get the hang of them now, but I mean... Did you not see that overshoot back there? That was farcical. It was a farcical popsicle. I might just note that phrase, it's pretty joke. Number 68. Right, see Falkirk on the map now, so I'm gonna throttle back. Hopefully not overshoot this time. No promises though. A couple of cows there. I always wonder why cows sit down when it rains. Like, I don't always wonder why cows lie down when it rains. Are they just because they want to keep the grass dry or something like that? Right, irrelevant facts over, just bloody irrelevant talk over, brakes on please. Hold them. What's that? Hold. Apply hold. I think the brakes aren't enough as it is now, I suppose. Well, that was an interesting sound effect. Now, hopefully, we stop in a reasonable place this time because we are bang on time, more or less. Could have made my time up now, so that's good. We're bang on, because I think that's what that means. Because it keeps fluctuating between hold and emergency. Because I want me to put emergency brakes on, obviously. Right, good. We're there. Oh, we stopped right on the line. Check that. Look at that, we stopped right at the end. Or just about. Screen capping that. Well, the back could be closer. All the doors are open, so take that as a take that as all right. Just gonna release the brakes a little bit, just so we're not hovering on emergency. Right, come on. Come on, thing. Hopefully I do better this time. And it's Croy and then Queen Street. Okay, let's go. Release brake. As soon as it releases, cane it. Let's go. Says I'm trying to make those on time for Falkirk High. I'm gonna try and make as much time as I can as we go along, just so I hopefully get a reasonable score. I mean, bronze medal I'd tolerate. I'll just say that. I'll tolerate a bronze medal for first try, especially how this farcical popsicle of a braking system has fucked me in the ass during this video. And I've literally had to do three takes all because of Spadden, because of this prick right here. Look at it mocking me. So look at it, it's going, ha 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 ha, I made you do three takes because I suck. Nah, sod you, seriously. Anyway, I'm starting to get the hang of you now, so don't gloat now. Alright? No need for gloating, I've got the hang of you. Alright, anyway, enough bitching. We're going up to 73, 74. Yeah, we should hopefully know our basic maths, but anyway, Croy's in 9 miles, which is not too far. What else is to do? I suppose I'm going to do a little quick little tracks I can. That's good enough. No, don't want to see progress. I want to see the HUD off. The whole of this thing is literally non-existent. Oh yeah, so DSD's not gone yet. Might just try and induce that, but I don't think we're going to induce it anytime soon. Probably because we're not going to be accelerating for a solid minute at this rate. Doesn't seem very likely that we'll be accelerating for a solid minute. Because this trainer does accelerate reasonably fast. At least in a full notch it does. At least when you give it the beans like I am right now. Right. I'm not going to slow down just yet. I just want to see if I can induce the DSD and show you guys how it works, for those who don't know. Got to a bridge. This is an interesting little area, because you got like a little random hut here. It looks like it must be like public talks or something. I'm just guessing. Got houses right here by Rowell. I don't know why I like to live there for some reason. Oh yeah, because I can watch the trains go by the window. Sorry about that, my mouse jumped. I don't know why. My mouse does that sometimes, it's annoying. It might just be like this, and then the mouse just might just like blip for no apparent reason. It might just like do that. Like you saw there. Not sure where we started, so not sure if the DSD is gonna come on or not. I don't even know if it's on, to be honest with you. Hopefully it is, because I'm gonna show you how it works. So you just drive it on like this, right? And then DSD will come on at some point. Come on, hurry up, really 5 miles out, hurry up. Come on, DSD, I think it's been over a minute now. I think it must be isolated. Might have to look at how you de-isolate it if it isn't already. What's that? Instrument dial lights. Instrument light. Right, since we're only 4.5 miles out, I might just throw back in a bit. A lot of AWS ramps here, that's odd. That's engine start, stop. Alarm for what? That's the parking brake. Please tell me that's not been off this whole time. Please tell me not have the parking brake on this whole time. Oh crap. I guess I had the parking brake on. I guess the parking brake was off then. Alright. Hopefully this is... Wait, there's an emergency brake override in here. That's what's the potential. There's an emergency brake override in here, quick. Wait, what's this? Loco main. Oh. Mass controller. Loco main. Password set area. Sodgy, man. Reset day guard. Oh, God. There's no DSD override, is there? I mean, AWS override. I mean, emergency brake override, excuse me. There's no emergency brake override button, is there? There's no override button, is there? Well, great, that's all my time lost again. Whoopee. Because I am an idiot. Let's go, come on. Sander? That's not Sander. Does Sander work? I'm not sure if Sander works in a straight or just a bump. No, I don't even know if the parking brake's on or not now. I'll sod it. We're not going to do a mile. I don't think we're going to do a mile a minute yet, are we? What is a mile a minute? I'm not going to try and work it out. So it looks like, looks like Germany beat, I mean, it looks like France beat Germany at the Euros. Congratulations to them. Not sure who they'll face in the final, though. I think that's a semi-final, so I think the final's next. Not sure who they'll face in the final, though. And I can see Crow on the map, so we're going to throttle back now. Throttle back. And I don't know how late I dare to brake, but might start braking now, actually. Apply it to 4 bar. Hold at 4. Just start slowing down. That is in bar, right? Yeah, it's in bar. Okay, 4 bar. So, or just under 4 bar we're holding at. Holding it 4 bar. And, I can add more bar if I want. I can take away some more bar if I want to, but I'm not sure what the limit is. Before the emergency brakes screw me over again. Although I think a just under 4 bar might be alright, because we're down to 40 odd now. We're coming into Croy. And then Queen Street's next. Might just take a little bit more. Might just take a little bit more bar out of the brake pipe and then put it into the brake cylinder, but 4 bars since you're working a street here. As we've only arrived a minute late, shouldn't be too much of a penalty for that. Just take away, add some bar to the pipe pressure we've got, and then go back up to around 4 bar. Hold it there. Trying to hold. We have. And open doors. There's some graffiti on that. I thought some graffiti on it, just the water droplets made me think it's so. Anyway, let's just have a quick look around Croy while we someone's beeping a horn for no reason. In the game, not in my area. Go to the back. No idea how accurate this depiction of Croy is, but it should be reasonably accurate. A bit of tunnel reverb there. And can now go. Release. Not 4, just to get it going. Just give it a little bit of throttle just to get going, then I'll bang it in. Get it going. And hopefully we can at least get to Queen Street on time and end on a high that way. Well, train's running well, so that's alright by me. Quick little tracks I can just to end those. Okay, we're currently 10 miles from Queen Street, which is means we should be motoring on reasonably well. We're still ETA 825 though, so hopefully that'll go down. Because we need to be there by 824. So, just hoping that that goes down by the time we near Queen Street. Oh, don't want to come like on. Could put the instrument lights on, but I don't really need them. I think that's, is that the master key? No. That's the most half-assed master key going. Right. Right. Going 96, near 97. Currently 8.5 miles from Queen Street, which is always nice. Not really, because it means you're not there yet. Just in case. Because they said it was a minute, didn't they? So I'm not sure whether or not it's on. Should find out if it is. Because it starts to stop accelerating at this point and just maintain speed at this point, so that's alright. Well, it's been 30 seconds or thereabouts now, so that could mean could come on any second now. Hopefully it will, probably it won't. Well, it's been a minute and it's not come on, so I don't know. If a DSD does come on, probably isolated it somewhere, haven't we? If it need DSD might have been isolated, but I'm not sure. There's a cab heating. There's a brake. TPWS isolation. That's probably it. Now we're back in the seat. I'm just seeing on the map going to slow down to 85 at some point. Well, 1.6 miles. So I'm going to start that now. Throw back. Hopefully get down to 85 in time, otherwise I'll have to deal with the dreaded braking system in this thing once again, which is, to say the least, farcical. Because, I mean, the difference between applying and accidentally putting emergency brakes on is, I don't even know, about a second, or not even that, probably. Since we have to slow down, keep slow down to 50 in addition, now we'll keep slowing down. Just so we don't miss that, but not just yet. Might just keep coasting for a little bit now, despite the fact it's slowed down by 19 miles per hour in a little bit. All in all, this is still a good add on this though. Just a quick look outside while we just get between this here. Oh, just saw that. Oh crap. So that's what I'm doing wrong. I'm putting it all the way. I don't have to put it in all the way. See, all the way will put the emergency brakes on, but just putting it somewhere won't. Not putting it all the way, won't put the emergency brakes on, so that's what I'm doing wrong. Right, so, learnt that, alright then. So, putting it all the way will engage the emergency brakes, but just putting it on there won't. Fine. Nah, I just lost nearly all my points. Alright, hopefully we probably like lost all our time doing that now. Oh, wheel slip. Damn it. Sorted. Bit of wheel slip sorted. Got to slow down to 40 at some point. About half a mile, or around half a mile, 0.55 miles, which is around half a mile. as 0.5 is half a mile. Gonna throttle back now. So we don't exceed 50, and more importantly, we can slow down to 40 on time. Okay, just gonna keep coasting for a little bit now. And hopefully this incline here won't present too many issues. 1.3 miles from Queen Street, so we're nearly there. Which means I can spare myself with this farcical braking system faster. And hopefully, not a moment too soon, we are now speeding. Hold it there. Hold the brake there. Gonna bring it back down just under 4 bar or around 4 bar. Just so we don't slow down catastrophically. Well, not really catastrophically, but just grind to a halt for no apparent reason. I'll just hold it there, actually. Well, I can't really hold it there for too long since we're accelerating ever so slightly. Depends what we tap out at, but I don't think we'll... Not sure if we'll top out at 30 or thereabouts. Is that a 68? But some of those are 170. I'm not sure what that is. Well, we're going to be at Queen Street in 2 minutes if we're going to pull anything off at all. Which I don't think we will be, because we've got to slow down to 15, but more importantly, AWS is being an ass. Still yellow, 68, it's fine. Right, yeah, we're slowing, we're speeding up, we're going to slow down. Sorted. Why do we get annoying, so stop them. Turn those off. And now the bloody release brakes. I thought the AWS was gonna come on, but it hasn't. Just wipe the windscreen, just so we don't have any stuff in our face. Set off and slow down to 15 as soon as we come out. It's going to add around, puts around 4 bar. And put the winter brakes on again while doing so. Bet they don't do it. There's no way to override the winter brakes, is there? There's no override button in here, is there? Oh man, that sucks. Right, let's just go. Part 4, notch 4. Not too long since we got since limit's 15. Idle. Somehow speeding still. And 8:24, so we're on time, happily. So this journey does have a happy ending, thankfully. That's if one, the emergency brakes don't come on now, and two, while doing so, we don't stuff a train while we do this. Put it on 4 bar. Hold. Turn the wipers off. Wipers off. DRA on. Doors. Tail lights. Put those on. tails on. No, I want it to put tails on, please. Wait. Is that all they do? Is that the only setting? Ah, there we go, tails. Right. Tails are on. And turn off ETS. Right, so it's complete. Select scenario 68.2, Scott Rail save return trip from the crew menu for it to return the express range back to Edinburgh. So I'll do that in the next video. So anyway, that is going to be... So that is the end of this video. So if you have any suggestions for a future Train Summit 2016 video, be sure to leave your comments down below. And that was the Class 68. I've been Tal Films. I will see you next time. Peace, yo. Thank you very much for watching. Be sure to subscribe for more content if you haven't already. Also, be sure to follow me on Facebook and Twitter for all the latest updates and stream times. Also, be sure to follow me on Twitch to watch all my live streams and get email notifications when I go live. Also, why not check out the latest video by clicking the annotation on the screen. I've been Tal Films, you've been yourself, and have a nice day.